New developments tonight in the case against Casey Anthony. Prosecutors want the judge to reject a list of 7 new defense witnesses. In their new motion, prosecutors say Anthony's defense has not shown good cause why the witnesses should be allowed now that a deadline has passed. They include 2 of Anthony's jailhouse confidants, an Orlando TV reporter, a former Texas Equisearch volunteer, and a New York attorney.
And meanwhile, the owner of a court reporting service is accusing the Anthony defense team of making false statements to the court. WESH 2's Bob Keeling joining us live right now with more on the new controversy and reaction to it. Bob?
Well, Martha, the owner of a Tennessee-based court reporting service accuses the members of the Anthony defense team of, quote, shenanigans to get him to deeply discount his normal rate and then misrepresenting to the court why he would not honor that rate. It's another dispute the Anthony defense does not need. In this letter to Judge Belvin Perry this week, the owner of a Knoxville court reporting service says a member of Jose Baez's legal staff used jargon he didn't understand, then incorrectly assumed the court reporter had agreed to deeply discounted rates the state of Florida pays for services on behalf of indigent clients.
They don't dot their I's, they don't cross their T's, they don't get confirmation from people.
In this letter, the owner of Stogsdale Court Reporting Services says the defense told Judge Belvin Perry the reason he would not honor the discounted rate was because the job was difficult and took more time than expected. These statements are not true, Gerald Stogsdale writes. I cannot ignore the attack on my integrity and reputation without responding.
If there's any moralist story, it's that you should get everything in writing before you engage in any activity for another person. And that seems to be the problem here. It's a miscommunication on the part of the defense.
Jose Baez did not return our request for comment, but in a previous letter, Cheney Mason's legal assistant asked Stogsdale why he didn't bring up this issue when he received the contract from the JAC, the Florida agency that handles indigency payments. But being in Tennessee, Stogsdale says, he has no idea who the JAC is. 2 other late-breaking developments to tell you about tonight in the case against Casey. Prosecutors are asking Judge Perry to strike defense challenges to tests allegedly showing chloroform in the air in Casey's car and months of plant and root growth around Kaylee Anthony's remains. Both issues are due to be argued in court next month.
Bob.